I said many times the Varroa mite is the number one enemy of honeybees. However, after last week, I think I'm gonna change that title to beekeepers. I was reading comments from my followers, happily answering questions and interacting with them, when I started to see a dangerous pattern. I was shocked. My followers have started to have very concerning ideas to improve the beekeeping industry. It was too many people with similar ideas and even talking to each other, making plans to find ways to do this terrible thing. That was the moment that I realized that I need to do something about that. And here we are in this emergency video to discuss once and for all why transporting bees from one country to another, it is a bad idea. This video is brought to you by our fans on Patreon. Hi, I'm Dr. Roberto Boncristiani, and this is Inside the Hive.tv, the show that takes you into the world of bees. If you like bees and want to know more about them, please consider subscribing and also hit the bell button so you don't miss a single video. In my last video series, we are talking about how the queen breeding programs start in the United States. We are revising the main scientific publications about the subject, and we are far away from finishing it. And because we started to talk about some genetic traits found in ape cerana, the Asian honeybee, that make them resistant to Varroa mite infestation, people at home start to think, wait a second, if this honeybee in Asia can already handle Varroa mites, why not bring them over and use them in our beekeeping operations? I'm a genius! Okay, I got it. It seems reasonable to think that. What is the big deal? Apes mellifera, the honeybee we have in the United States, is already an introduced species. So why not to introduce another one to help the beekeepers in America? Here is the problem. When a new species found a new environment where they were never before, it is impossible to predict the consequences of this introduction to all other organisms already living in the same environment. And that includes the honeybee apes mellifera that we have here. As a Brazilian-American, I have a great example to share. In the 50s, Dr. Warwick Kerr, a famous scientist trying to improve the beekeeping industry in Brazil, also had another wonderful idea. The European honeybees apes mellifera brought to America is not adapted to the tropical environment of Brazil. Maybe that's why the honeybees here in Brazil are not performing well. Why not bring African honeybees to Brazil to improve the beekeeping industry? I'm a genius! Just like my dad liked to say, hell is full of well-intended people. In 1956, Dr. Kerr personally brought honeybee queens from South Africa, Apes mellifera scutellata, a different race of Apes mellifera, and started to experiment with them in Brazil. Long story short, the queens escaped, and now we have Africanized honeybee taking over all the Americas. Did they improve the beekeeping industry? Well, yes, I cannot deny there was a big improvement, but not totally because of the new race of Africanized bees introduced, but also because beekeepers were forced to become better beekeepers. However, I am sure all the bad consequences that include dead people and many other animals were not included in Dr. Kerr's calculations. By the way, if you want to know everything about Africanized honeybees in America, please sign up to my email list because my online course is almost ready and it's going to be released at the end of this year. Sign up to the email list so you can get updates. The case of Africanized bees is a great example of how unpredictable moving bees around can be. The transport of ape cerana, a completely new honeybee species in America, could be devastating. Let's start talking about what they carry with them. Honeybees can carry lots of pests and pathogens. One of the most problematic introductions that we scientists can think of would be the introduction of another terrible mite, Tropilalepse. Tropilalepse are much more dangerous threat to honeybees than Varroa mites. Take this recent example. Just a couple years after the introduction of Tropilalepse to Pakistan, Pakistan lost almost 100% of its honeybee colonies to this pest. Not a joke. We're talking about a threat capable to dismantle the beekeeping industry in the United States. Tropilalepse reproduce more and faster than Varroa and can carry several of the same viruses Varroa mite can carry. I made a video about Tropilalepse a long time ago, way before Dr. Sammy Ramsey started researching them. Please take a look at the video. It is old and needs some updates, but it's still good to learn how to differentiate them from Varroa mites. So let me just reemphasize that tropillary labs is only one problem. Honeybees can carry different things with them: viruses, bacteria, fungi. For you to have an idea how many pests and pathogens a honeybee can bring with them, you just need to go to this amazing website. And yes, this is a shameless self-promotion where myself, together with Dr. Jamie Ellis from the University of Florida and a great team of other scientists, put together a website where everybody can go and see all the pests and pathogens that affect honeybee apis mellifera. Visit worldhoneybeehealth.com and check it out, all other problems that transporting bees can carry with them. The introduction of a new species is a big problem because apis cerana can carry a variety of different pathogens and pests that the honeybee here, apis mellifera, do not have any protection against. They will for sure damage the beekeeping industry here pretty bad. So if you are one of these people at home considering the idea to transport bees from Asia to America, please stop. This is a terrible idea and you don't want to be responsible for a catastrophe. Please stop. The second problem with the introduction of apis cerana would be the competition between the two species. Now you have another honeybee species, not very good for beekeeping, competing for the same resources. Apis cerana don't grow well, as we are normally used with apis mellifera, and also they swarm like hell and abscond a lot. A true nightmare for American beekeeping practices. But that's not the only problem. Interspecific mating between apis cerana and apis mellifera may occur, with various outcomes ranging from hybridization to reproductive interference. To explain that well, I will need a whole video series about that. But long story short, apis mellifera and apis cerana living in the same area could potentially inhibit each other's normal development, putting in risk their own survival. The introduction of biological material is always risky and needs to be done carefully after well-calculated risk assessment. The case of Brazil is not a good example of how things should be done. And there is a chance the release of African bees was premeditated, as I discussed this in my online course. I just come from Georgia Beekeeping Association meeting in Gainesville, where I met Dr. Mohamed Aburaki from the USDA ARS in Beltsville. In his presentations, he showed how genetically homogeneous the honeybee population in the United States is. Apparently, more than 90% of apis mellifera in the United States is the same haplotype, meaning that there is no much genetic diversification in the US population. The lack of genetic diversification into the honeybee population in the United States is a big problem, and to me explain why most of the queen breeding programs tend to fail. It is hard to select something when you don't have the diversity. And we might need to think about introduction of different genetic material into the US population to perhaps help the beekeeping industry. But this is a very complicated issue, just like I mentioned here. There is a lot of risk. You cannot predict things very well. But this is a subject for another video. We have a lot to talk about those things in the future. And for now, please watch this video right here to learn more about bees. And I will see you in the next video, inside the hive.tv, the show about bees. See you guys next week.